I am spell bound. How to start, what to speak, if words don't flow. My dear friends, colleagues from DCS, NMR facility, friends from all over the country. I am extremely honored and touched by this love and respect which you have shown. Firstly, we are organizing the conference, showcasing the high quality research that various people are carrying out in the area of which was to my heart, and then expressing your love and affection from the core. Memories are coming back, of course they will stay. These things will stay forever. I will continue to do my best to keep in touch wherever I am with all of you. And keep abreast with the progress you are making. If you excel and do better than what I am doing, which you are, there can be nothing more satisfying than that for a teacher. I have enjoyed working with all the students, all the teachers, and I've learned a lot from all of them. In fact, the students are your teachers as well. Years is a long time. In TIFR, naturally I have become nostalgic about this place. And these things will remain. These things will remain. So many people have influenced me administratively, scientifically. I have been associated with 6 directors of TIFR, starting with Professor Sri Kantan, although Professor Menon was also there when I was here, but I didn't have an opportunity to interact with him. Professor Sri Kantan, followed by Professor Virendra Singh, Professor Jha, then Professor Shobha Bhattacharya, Professor Mustansir Verma, and now Sandeep Trivedi. All of them have made such an unforgettable impact in various ways on my life. The advice that I have received from all of these people has been instrumental in shaping my ways of life. Some of you talked about the expression and things like that. You learn this by experience. When you interact with various people, various personalities, you have to carry them along. So you do make corrections along the way, how to deal with things. My mentors, Professor Govil, who was my PhD supervisor, has made such a deep impact on me. How to remain cool? There is one thing which, of course, when all of you will not dispute, Professor Govil has been one of the coolest persons. He established the NMR facility here in 1973, and which was supported by all the NMR scientists. Professor Anil Kumar, who could not be here, Professor Ramanathan, Sir Surya Prakash, Sir Ajit Kumar, all of these people have made such an impact on my life, in my research. I learned a lot from all of these people. The only objective in life has to be to excel. No matter what field you choose, you have to excel. This you can achieve if you have the integrity, the honesty, truthfulness, the values which are required for excelling in any field of life, any walk of life. These things we learned along the way. Education, of course, has therefore played a very crucial role. The early education, the school education, the college education, this plays a very important role in one's life. So these values you learn during this school education. I don't want to talk about the research and things like that. That has happened, the support from TIFR and all of those who have been here doing research realize that TIFR is a paradise for the research. Nowhere in the world you get such kind of flexibility and freedom and support. Only when you go out from here, you start realizing what constraints are there in life. Here it is unlimited flexibility, unlimited freedom, and support for quality science. You produce quality, there is support. And that has been the driving force. Wherever we go, we try to implement this. So this is called as TIFR culture. I carried this with me when I went to CBS as well. So you try to implement that kind of a culture of being objective in whatever you are doing. Personalities come and go. Differences come and go. But the ultimate objective, when it is positive, positive attitude, it always thrives. Negativity can never thrive. This is what I learned from my experiences. Negativity can never lead to an accomplishment. It's always a positive attitude. Look at the good things from the people whom you interact with. Pick out those. Forget the negative things. Nobody is a perfect man in this world. Everybody has shortcomings. Forget the shortcomings, but look at the positive aspects of the persons and you learn from them. And that is the message which I got from all my teachers, from all my colleagues, all the friends, interacting with so many people here and in CBS. Hurdles are there, but you have to overcome it. You have to have the conviction that this can be done. If you have the conviction, nobody will stop you. Nobody can stop you. You will find ways to get around whatever hurdles come by. So with all of these things, you pursue your work, whether it is research, whether it is administration, or whatever. And I also felt that along with your profession, there must also be a passion. Because these things are very helpful, rejuvenating yourself. If you have a passion for something else, me, in my case, it has been music. But some people have passion for art, painting, something else. So these things always help in rejuvenating yourself from the difficult problems you may come across in your professional life. So this always has helped me. When the NMR facility was created, it was a great effort. As I mentioned, Professor Govil started it. The NMR facility people, A.D. Rampura was there at that time, Professor Chari. Full commitment to it. Mamta is here, Manoj is here, Devidas. That kind of a dedication and commitment to work for it, for the growth of it. See that ultimately it is the functioning of that facility which matters, nothing else matters. You find a way out, find a way out. Professor Saran, who was also my PhD mentor during the time when Professor Govil was not here. He took charge of the NMR facility for many years. Following that, I had the fortune of looking after that facility.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Don't forget Sudha.
Yeah, I said everybody. All NMR facility people, of course. Sudha Srivastava, unfortunately, she is having some difficulty now, but her husband passed away, unfortunately. That was a tragedy. I went to see her. So, all the people in the NMR facility have contributed immensely to the growth of the NMR facility. It has acquired international reputation. In fact, the DST wanted us to expand. It is not that we wanted to expand initially. DST wanted us to expand. Since you are doing so much service to the country, you must do more service by expanding. However, we don't have that kind of a space here. Therefore, we thought we will generate a new center. So that proposal was made. Now it is coming, taking shape in Hyderabad. Now Sandeep Trivedi is in the deep of that one now. That is growing, that is developing, and that will become a big center in due course of time. I have learned many things from my friends in TIFR and outside, who always have stayed beside me, shared my stress, shared my joy on various occasions. Of course, everybody goes through various ups and downs in his life. So during various times, my students have been the greatest support. Of course, why is here? So many of the students are here. And they have put up such a wonderful, wonderful program today. And in all of these, they have stood by with me, providing a support which is very much required. My family, starting from my grandparents, parents, parents-in-laws, brothers, sisters, and their counterparts-in-laws, they have been a great support, great admirers, very passionate about what I do all along. During this period, I also had an opportunity to serve the society in a different sense, going over to the Center for Excellence in Basic Sciences, which I had an opportunity to set up that. Of course, it had a lot of difficulties. There's a lot of difficulties, but we have to get over those. So if you only keep complaining the difficulties are there, you will never go forward. So difficulties are always there. So we have to get over those difficulties. And this, I'm glad that we could achieve this. So now the center has become an aided institution like any other institution. We often said that this is supposed to be a model for other universities to follow. And two, by Mumbai University, I used to go and tell the Vice Chancellor, look, I have brought a TIFR in your campus. How? Firstly, the culture. And so many people from here are coming and teaching there, contributing to the wisdom, the ideas, quality of teaching is ensured. Therefore, you don't make the mistake of losing it out. If you don't cooperate with me, there is a big chance that you will lose it out, and don't do that. You have got a TIFR on your campus. And of course, that did carry weight. That is, initial resistance disappeared. Things came by. And because initially the university was of the opinion, why should this become an institution, independent institution. Let DA give money to us. We will run it. We will give the money to you. I said, no, that is not the way. It cannot work that way. Otherwise, it will become like the university. No growth, whatever. But we have to resurrect the university system. And many other universities have to do it. And therefore, we are setting an example here to develop this. And then, in due course, when it happens elsewhere, it will change the education scenario in the country as a whole. In fact, now I think there is a serious thought about in the national education policy, as Dr. Sandeep Trivedi tells me. He's becoming, has taken note of this. National Education Policy Committee has taken note of this. And I'm quite positive that this will take a great shape. In all of this, I owe to a lot of people. Finally, since there is not too, I don't want to speak for too much time, I don't want to talk science here, much time. The one person who has been immensely responsible for my career is Medhavini, my wife. Her support is not measurable. Her dedication to work, commitment, insatiable desire to learn, and positive attitude towards life. She loved all my students as her own children. She took care of them as her own children, cared for their stresses, and therefore, and we can see the kind of love she got from the students in return. So the message I give here, I get here is, what you can achieve by loving people, you cannot achieve by anything else. Coercion can never achieve anything. It is only the love that can achieve. It is limitless. Any other means has limits. If love the people, care for them, see what is good for them, you can suggest, of course they have their independence to think and do whatever they want. But with sincerity, if you think and make your positive contributions towards that, that will be the long-lasting thing that can happen. So once again, I thank you all and I dedicate this to Medhavini. Thank you all for all the effort and for all the love and affection you have showered on me and my family. And I'm sure this culture will continue with all my students and all the colleagues. And this is an extremely memorable occasion to remember for me. Thank you very much.